Hello, everyone. Thank you for having me. My name is Marlita Hill, and I am the author of Nail That Niche. And I'm excited to come to speak to you today about the importance of defining your work via nailing your niche. So I just want to tell you really quickly about my approach to niching. I am a slasher, which means that I work in several areas. So when I was defining my own niche, I had to develop a process that would allow space and room for the various areas that I work in. So I know sometimes when we talk about defining our work or nailing our niche, sometimes some of us are multi-passionates out there, get a little clenchy for fear. But I'm speaking to you as a fellow multi-passionate who has been able to do this. And if you ever want to talk to me about it, you know, hit me up. Anyway, so let's get into this because I want to respect your time. So there are two important reasons for defining your work as an entrepreneur. The first one is that starting and running a business is essentially an enterprise in making decisions. From what you're going to name your business to the colors you use for your branding to the tone of voice that you use to what you're going to name your products and services. Are you going to do products or services? Where are you going to base your business? Is it going to be online or brick and mortar? Are you going to create a course, a product? All of those are decisions that you have to make as an entrepreneur that are essential to running your business. And it's important that you have anchoring information to help you in making those decisions so that you can make strategic decisions that are constructing what you're actually trying to build. Because without that anchoring information, you could be making decisions that are taking your business other places you didn't intend it to go. So that's the first reason. Starting and running a business is all about making decisions, and you need anchoring information about the nature of your work to help you make strategic decisions that lead you and move your business towards what you're actually trying to build. Yes? The second important reason for defining our work is that a lot of the business to-dos that we have in running our business are actually endeavors of translation. And here's what I mean. So let's say you wanted to get a logo created for your business, right? Well, so you go and you work with a graphic designer to create the logo. Well, the graphic designer doesn't tell you what your work is about, right? What they do is they take your work that you have defined and they use their expertise in design and they translate the information about your work into a visual representation of your work via a logo. A website designer does the same thing. A web designer, and I learned this the hard way, a web designer does not give you what your work is about. You actually have to give them that information. And then they use their design expertise, their coding expertise, to translate what your work is about, again, into a visual representation via a website, and on and on and on. The name of your business, right, is a language representation of what your work is about. So all of these things that are really important for us to engage in running our business are endeavors of translation. And you have to have something to be translated before you can translate it into a visual representation, a language representation, copy, website, all of that stuff. They have to work from something. If you have nothing to give them, then it's very hard for them to produce what you want. Yeah. So those are two big reasons for us to define our work. Now, let's get into the actual defining of the work. And I believe, and I have found, that defining your work is like making a salad. In that, I mean, It is a process of preparation and assembly. And here's what I mean with making a salad. When you're making a salad, you don't grab a whole tomato, a whole head of lettuce, a whole cucumber, a whole carrot, a whole bell pepper, and whatever else you want to put in that fancy salad. You don't just take the whole of each of those things and throw them in a bowl and serve it. That's not how you make a salad. At least I hope not, right? Each of those ingredients actually has to be prepared first. You've got to wash it, chop it up however you want it chopped, season it if that's what you do. And then you take each of those prepared ingredients and you assemble the prepared ingredients in a bowl, and that makes the salad. Well, defining our work is the same process, right? There are things that we have to prepare, and then we assemble those prepared things into a description, a statement, an understanding about our work. So what are the things that need to be prepared for our business? That is answers. There are answers that you have to get prepared. And then you assemble those answers into a description or statement that explains the nature of your work, the people you serve, and the problems you solve. Okay? So in my session, I'm going to give you four questions that you need to answer. Right? That you need to answer and then assemble into a definition or statement that explains your work. Here we go. The first question that you need to answer is, how do you show up and participate in your industry? What role or function do you play? What position, and I don't mean job title, but just function, what position do you stand in? And here's why this is important. Each industry is made up of many participants. Each participant engages in the industry in a specific way and shows up in a specific capacity. Each one, each participant, takes on a certain role or function. So my work, for instance, is an intersection of faith, art, and entrepreneurship. So I am working either in one of those areas by themselves or in some combination of them, but they all center around those three areas. So one of the areas of my work is in dance education. Okay, so let's say dance education is the industry. Okay, in that industry, there are a lot of different positions that people take. There are teachers, there are students, there are parents of those students, there are merchandisers, there are schools and schools administrators, lots of different positions, functions, roles that people take in dance education. So what's important for me is to define which of those functions or roles am I, right? And this is what you have to answer for you. So one of the things that I've come to understand is that my position that I take in the dance education industry or space is that of a teacher, right? That's how I show up. When I engage in that space, I engage from the perspective of a teacher. When I interact with other positions, I do so as a teacher. Same with you. It's important for you to define how do you show up in the space of your industry, okay? Question number two is, what kind of blank are you? And for me, that would be, what kind of teacher am I? What differentiates me from others doing the same kind of work? And this is important because there are many other participants within your industry that do the same thing you do. However, you don't all do that same thing in the same way. So let's just take the city that I'm in. Within something just as small as my city, there are lots of other teachers who are teaching dance in the dance education space, right? So we're all in the position of a teacher, or should I say we all share the same position of a teacher, but we don't all teach in the same way. We don't all teach the same ages, right? We don't all have the same approach to teaching. We don't all teach the same subject. Even though it's dance, there's lots of different subjects in dance. We don't all teach in the same environment, and we don't all teach to achieve the same goal. There are differences, even though we all share the same position of being a teacher of dance, right? Okay, so for you, in the same way, whatever that position is that you hold, there are lots of other people that hold that same position. What is it that differentiates you in that position? Okay. Question number three is, how does your audience participate in your industry? What position, again, not job title, but what position do they hold? So, again, we'll go back to my example of the dance education space. Again, there are students, schools, performance space owners, there are merchandisers, parents, community. So my position as a teacher, who's my audience? Who's my target audience? The clients that I want to serve with my work? Is it that I am a consultant for parents who want a teacher's advice for the educational path their student, their child should take if they want to go to Broadway? Do I work with schools in rural neighborhoods, and I have a cadre of teachers that I contract out who have specialized training or that provide specialized training, right? And so I contract these teachers out or to after school programs who don't have access to dance education, right? Who are my actual clients in this industry? So for me, the clients that I serve are students, people who are wanting to learn how to dance or to receive dance training. So my industry is dance education. My position within the dance education industry is teacher. That's how I show up in that space. And then my client's position, the way they show up in that space, is as students, those who are wanting to receive dance training. Okay? In the same way, you have to decide, or define, should I say, which position your clients hold within your industry. And then the last question that you need to answer to define your work is, what audience experience, situation, or context does your work serve for your audience? And this is important because there are many who share your audience's position. However, not everyone who shares their position occupies it in the same experience, context, or situation. So my clients, my target audience, are students wanting to receive dance training. But there are students of all kinds who want to receive training of all kinds for all kinds of different reasons, right? Are my clients toddlers who parents want to put in classes to develop their creative movement or their creativity, right? Are my clients athletes who want to take dance classes to improve their agility in their sport, right? Are my clients couples who want to receive dance training to prepare for their wedding dance? Are my clients other dance teachers who want to improve and get professional development training, right? Or learn a different form or go deeper into a form or that kind of thing? There are all kinds of students, all kinds of reasons people want to be students of dance. And so it's important for me to clarify the experience and the situation that my work addresses, right? So those are the four questions that you need to answer in your work, right? So you have your industry. What is the position that you serve within that industry? How do you show up in that space? Number two, what differentiates the work that you do in that position from all the other people that are in that position? I mean, that you can identify. Number three, What position does your client, your target audience, take? And number four, in that position, what is their experience or situation, the actual context you serve? Because you don't serve all students. You serve, or should I say, let me say me. I don't serve all students. I serve a particular kind of student. I specifically serve students who want dance training because they are pursuing a professional dance career, right? Those are the students that I serve. Now, if other students come into my class for other different reasons, that's fine. But everything about the work that I do is geared towards a particular aim, okay? So my work with Nail That Niche is to walk you through the process of defining those questions, of answering those questions, and helping you assemble. And so if that's something that you need help with, I encourage you to reach out to me. You can either find me at marlitahill.com or at nailthatniche.com, and I would love to help you out. I have a course that can walk you through, or I do personal consultations. But I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for giving me your time. Please go and define your work. It's going to help you make strategic decisions that help you save time, save money, and save precious confidence. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. And I will see you all hopefully soon.